ready.
Today, at the outset, I wanted to thank the 35,000 viewers who have seen my earlier video, in which I have put forth the views of the 82,000 employees of ordnance factories, that what is going to be the danger the country is going to face if the Government of India's decision to corporatize ordnance factories is implemented. I am grateful to all the support we are receiving for the cause, in fact, a national cause for which we are fighting for. Today, I wanted to utilize this opportunity to bring certain facts before the public. Nowadays, it has become a fashion, it has become a fancy for some so-called self-claimed defense experts to abuse, to make malicious, reckless, mischievous and sweeping charges against the Indian Ordnance factories. Who are these people? All these people are sponsored by the corporates to create an opinion against the Indian Ordnance factories. Unfortunately, on many occasions, the ordnance factories, in the name of defense and in the name of being a government department, doesn't react to all these false and fabricated allegations. We know that many retired army officers, after retirement, they take various positions in private corporates. Some are sitting as vice president of the company, some are in the board of directors, and all these people, to serve the interest of the corporate company to which they are working, they start doing all these allegations. In the name of article, in the name of interview, in the name of statements, all these people get the undue publicity in the media. The media also nowadays, unfortunately, without considering the ethics of the media, without asking the other side, either the Ordnance Factory Board or we, the trade unions representing the Ordnance Factory employees, they publish all those statements. And these one-sided, fabricated and false statements go to the public, resulting in creating an impression amongst the public that the performance of ordnance factories are poor. Recently, one retired Major General by name, Mr. Sehgal, he has publicly charged in one of the media, in one of the YouTube TV channel, that ordnance factories are corrupted. What is the evidence before him for stating that, making that statement? Nobody knows. How many officers are arrested and jailed for corruption? That he has not told. But he has made a sweeping statement that ordnance factory is corrupted. Yes, like in any other government department or even in private sector, one or two bad elements may be here and there. And if those bad elements, if they have committed any corruption, they have to face the consequences. the law has to take its own action. But making a general statement that the ordnance factories is corrupt, that means are we 82,000 employees corrupt? So he has to answer this. Then he is being called as a technical expert by the media which has interviewed him. And he has started boosting his technical expertise by saying accidents are taking place during trials in the weapons, in the ammunitions being supplied by the ordnance factories. Is it a fact? Yes, in the recent past, some accidents have taken place during the trial. But the subsequent inquiries have proved that it is not because of the poor quality of the product of the ordnance factories. The ammunition's quality, the quality of the gun, after the inquiry, it is proved that is within the parameter of the quality specification. But then why the accident has taken place? It is because of the mishandling of the gun, sometime mishandling of the ammunition, sometime poor storage of the ammunition, sometime the soldiers who are handling are not being given proper training. These are all the reasons. But when any accident takes place, the immediate reports in the media comes that it is only because of the poor quality of the ordnance factories. And subsequently, when the issue is inquired and when the facts are revealed, those reports doesn't come in the press. And public carry the impression which has come in the press or media that the ordnance factory products are poor. So the inquiry reports are well within the government of India, and the army has got these reports. Similarly, one allegation the Major General has made about ULHM 777 ammunition. That also, on enquiry, it was found that there is no defect in the ammunition, either in the quality of the ammunition or the components available in the ammunition. That inquiry report is also with the government of India, but that has never come in the press. So this is how the ordnance factories are being abused, and ordnance factories are being subjected to all these type of sponsored malicious criticisms. Against this criticism, or the allegations made by Major General Sergal, we lodged a complaint with the public relations officer of the Ordnance Factory Board, and we have requested him that how you can leave such type of false propaganda which is damaging the image of the ordnance factories. You should make a complaint with the concerned TV channel, and if required, consult your legal advisor and file an FIR or issue a legal notice for defamation. Already we are subjected to trouble. Our products are being outsourced. Now the government want to corporatize the ordnance factories. The workforce is fighting. A strike notice has been issued. And how can Ordnance Factory Board remain a silent spectator? Of course, we are thankful to the PRO of the OFB. Immediately he has taken up the matter with the concerned TV channel, and they have immediately deleted that interview of Major General Sergal. This is what has happened. Our achievements, nobody is telling. Now the present Secretary DP is advocating for intellectual property right. But nobody knows the story that one of the ordnance factory by name Ordnance Clothing Factory Abadi, which has developed the design, the pattern of the battlefield dress which today our soldiers are wearing, which has improved the image and personality of our soldier, that design is patented by Ordnance Clothing Factory Abadi in 2006 itself. We are a pioneer. Like that, many items ordnance factories have patented. But now the government says all those patented items, you give the design to the private sector so that the private sector can easily procure these items. So the government also should understand. On the one side, the government is telling you go for intellectual property rights. And when we do that, when we register the pattern, when we register the design developed by us, because the government has declared those items as non-core, you are putting pressure on the Ordnance Factory Board that you hand over the design to the NGO, to the DGOS, and who in turn will hand over the pattern to the private companies. Is it justified? Is it correct on the part of the government to do this? Then what is the purpose of this intellectual property right? There is no meaning. There is no meaning in this intellectual property right. Therefore, the Ordnance Factory Board has to take a position in this. Since Ordnance Factory Board is not coming out openly with all these achievements, at least we, the workforce, the employees, we have to tell the outside world what we are doing. Chandrayaan 2, which has been launched in the orbit. All appreciation to ISRO. Yes, they deserve all appreciation. Being a government organization, they have done a wonderful job. But the Ordnance Factory also played a very vital role in the launching of Chandrayaan 2. The pyrotech explosives, which is used for launching this Chandrayaan 2, was manufactured by whom? One of our ordnance factory, by name Ordnance Factory Bandara. It is their pyrotech explosives only the Chandrayaan 2 has used for launching the Chandrayaan 2 in the orbit. Anybody has appreciated? No doubt the Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, they have appreciated by issuing a letter to the senior general manager of Ordnance Factory Bandara. But no press has appreciated this. Even the government has not appreciated. Government appreciated only the scientist and the ISRO team. We do not have any complaint. They deserve all appreciation. But we also little bit deserve the appreciation. No. That is not coming from the government. Therefore, these type of mischievous, planned, sponsored allegations against the ordnance factories has to be stopped. This cannot be allowed to continue. Yes, we are a 218-year-old organization. How many technological developments have taken place in these 218 years? Ordnance Factory Board, generations of workers have absorbed all these new and latest technologies. While doing work, mistakes do happen. But we are not a stagnated organization. We are a dynamic organization. We correct our mistakes. We improve ourselves. And that is why the Master General Ordnance, when we met him, when a delegation of the AIDF met him, has openly stated that the Indian Army is more comfortable with the ordnance factories. The former army chief, immediately after the Kargil crisis, have appreciated the performance of the ordnance factories. The then president, Dr. K.R. Narayanan, in the parliament, he has appreciated the role played by ordnance factories during the Kargil crisis. The First World War, Second World War, after independence, Chinese aggression, the war with Pakistan, the Bangladesh Liberation War, Kargil crisis, surgical strikes, all these national defense strategies, requirements, it is we, the ordnance factories, have played a role. So it is in the interest of the nation that ordnance factory should not be destroyed. It should not be subjected to any liquidation. And that is why, knowing the policy of the government to privatize public sector, we are opposing the move of the government to corporatize the ordnance factories, because corporatization is the first step of privatization. Therefore, I once again appeal to the public of this country, to the people of this country, please extend support to our struggle. Please extend support to our cause that ordnance factory should continue as a government department. Thank you so much.
Your Honor, sir.